Hello people from the future, welcome to Normalized Nerd. So I'm continuing with my series on natural language processing, and this is the third video, and today I'm going to be talking about text cleaning and preprocessing. If you are new to my channel, then please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. I make videos about machine learning and data science regularly. So today's topic is actually very important in natural language processing because you need to filter your text as much as you can to get the best result, because you know that text data can be very diverse, and while cleaning the text you need to keep in mind what you are trying to do with your data, because the text cleaning and preprocessing will depend a lot on your application and your method towards the problem that you are trying to solve. So I will give you some examples of the common text preprocessing techniques, and I will tell you which one you should use in which case. So first of all, I am importing the two libraries, NumPy and Pandas, and I am applying the same technique to read my dataset, and the dataset is same as I have started from the first video of this series, which is the bag of words video. So I will definitely link that in my description, and also I will link that dataset in my description. Make sure to check previous two videos, because there I have covered bag of words model and tf-idf method. So this is my data frame, and these are my text, and from this I'm gonna make my corpus. Obviously we need to first clean this thing. So before cleaning, we need to import some of the important libraries that will help us to preprocess our data. So the important libraries here are NLTK library and the RE library, and we need the classes like word tokenizer, stop words, and potter streamer. So this is my huge text cleaning function. Obviously you don't need to use every method in this function for every machine learning problem regarding text. Well, I am just gonna give you all the techniques, and I will mention which one to use with which case. The first thing I like to do while preprocess our text, I just create an empty list. Okay, this will be our corpus. So I'm creating an empty list here, and the name is all reviews. Well, this is a data set about reviews, that's why the name. And then I'm just taking all my text data from my data frame. Okay, and then I'm traversing through each of the documents. Well, as I have told earlier, the document in NLP just means the instances of your corpus. So if you have 10 reviews, then you are gonna have 10 documents in your corpus. All right, okay. So the first thing that you want to do in your text preprocessing is to convert your text into lowercase, because in most of the cases we want to limit ourselves just to 26 English alphabets, and if we don't use this function, then we will have to deal with 52 alphabets, so that will definitely harm our model. But obviously, as I have told earlier, that what you are going to do in text preprocessing depends largely on your application. So if capital letters are useful for your application, so don't use that. So that you have to think yourself to use this function or not. But in most of the machine learning problems regarding text, we convert the text data into lower cases. Okay, and then this function actually removes all the website addresses from your dataset. Now when this scenario can occur, suppose you are working on social media data. For example, you are working on tweets or Reddit comments. So there is a high probability that you will encounter website links. Now, very rarely those website links are useful for your data analysis or your machine learning model. So if you are working with social media data, then it will be best if you just discard all the links. So this two line just removes every single string that starts with HTTP or HTTPS, and it just places an empty string there. Now this is actually very interesting, and I love it very much, because if you are working with social media data, especially chat data, then there is a high probability that you will find smileys and other emojis. Now it is really hard to incorporate these emojis in our machine learning model because we have a lot of options for these emojis, right? Just you can just open your smartphone and you will see hundreds of emojis. And the problem is different people use different emojis for the same mood. So that is really not a good idea to incorporate these emojis in our vocabulary. So we will just remove these emojis. And these codes you are seeing here are actually Unicodes for those emojis. So by using this sub function here, you can just replace these things with an empty string. Now, another thing I would like to mention here is that if you don't want to replace them with an empty string, you can actually replace them with a common string. So in this way, your model will know, okay, here is an emoji, not a word, and it can learn something from that. And the same trick you can actually use for your website addresses also. You can just replace all the web links with a common word. So in this way, your model will know, okay, there was a website link, if there's something is to learn at all. So after that, so these are actually expanding common short forms like am to I am, his to he is, what's to what is, and here apostrophe double L will expand to will, ve to have, didn't to did not. And why is it necessary? Whenever you want to do some sentiment analysis, this won't help you much because these things doesn't carry much sentiment, but these are pronouns and verbs. Now these kind of things will be very necessary for you if you not only want to classify some sentiment but also want to create text from your model. That is, if you want to make some kind of chatbot, then this kind of expansions will be very helpful for you because we humans use this kind of things, right? So whenever you want to produce human like text from your machine, you should definitely include them. After that, this is actually a common one, and here I am replacing every possible punctuation with an empty string. Now there is actually two examples I want to mention here. So whenever you are working with Twitter data, you will find this hashtags, right? And you don't really need the hash symbol in your data, but you want to have that hashtag. So it will be better for you if you just remove the hash symbol from the beginning of your data. So keep that in mind. And whenever you want to tag someone in Facebook or some other kind of social media websites, you will encounter this @ sign, right? So you don't really want to include that in your dataset, so you should also remove it. And for other kind of punctuations and symbol, it is always better to get rid of them because that doesn't carry anything meaningful. And you might be questioning yourself here, if I just remove every possible full stop from my corpus, then how will my model ever know when one sentence is ending and when some other sentence is beginning? So the answer is, we don't really use this full stop in NLP to denote the end of a statement. What we do, we use some special kind of tags. Okay, now comes this function, which is the tokenized function. And this is actually very important because in NLP, in most of the cases, we work with individual words, not a whole sentence at once, okay? And these two lines are also taking care of the punctuations. And now this line actually is discarding everything that is not an alphabet. So by this line, you will actually discard every single number from your dataset. And these three lines, I have actually commented them out, but these three lines will be necessary if you are working solely on sentiment analysis. This top words is actually the set of words that occur in a particular language very frequently. And for sentiment analysis, we really don't care about them. We care about the words which carry sentiment. Just to give you an example, let me show you some stop words. So these are actually the stop words you are seeing here. So for sentiment analysis case, you don't need to really use them. But for other applications like speech to text, machine translation, poem generation, you really want these words. So in those cases, you don't discard them. So after that, I am just joining those tokenized words into a single string. And at last, I am appending each string to our huge list. And at last, I am returning it. So I have actually printed first 20 of my sentences in my corpus. And if you notice carefully, you will see that there are no capital letters, there are no numbers, there are no punctuations. Okay. And another thing that I didn't write here, but I have shown you in my last video, is word stemming. Again, I'm saying that if you want to do sentiment analysis or some text classification thing, then you need to restrict your vocabulary. So for those cases, you want to use only the root word. For example, nearly, right? So there can be another word like near. So you can see that these two words, nearly and near, are different forms of the same word. So in those cases, we just take one, and probably we will take near. We will just discard ly, and this process is actually called word stemming. And for sentiment analysis and text classification, you should definitely go for it. But for other tasks, for other complex tasks where you are gonna use word embeddings, you may not do that. So let me just give you another example of text cleaning. So you can see that I am creating a data frame here, and the data frame contains only one column and one row, and in that row I'm putting this sentence which says, I will suggest you to open https://google.com and search nerdy wits. And I'm just naming my column review text, because in my function I have actually used that thing, so I really need to name that column. And after text cleaning and preprocessing, I have this sentence which says, I will. It has converted I into lowercase and it has expanded I will, and it has removed the website link, and again it has converted this capital nerdy bits to lowercase nerdy bits. By the way, Nerdy Bits is my Facebook page. Definitely check that out. I post nerdy memes there. So that was all for this video. So a quick recap. Text cleaning and preprocessing depends highly on the application and the data set you are working on. All right. So all these functions that I have shown here have their uses in particular cases, and you need to pick yourself which preprocessings are to be done for your NLP problem. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please share this video and subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching.